I've got 7 features in Adobe Premiere Pro that you have never heard about before. Or at least I hope so, or the title of this video is wrong. Anyways, talking about Premiere, recently we have set up a brand new YouTube channel on which we upload basic tutorial videos about Premiere Pro every week. So go check it out, Premiere Basics, from a link in the description down below, and don't forget to subscribe. Now let's get started. Premiere feature number 1, which you didn't know about before, and that is an audio effect called Loudness Radar. But instead of applying this to a clip, we're going to apply it from the effects rack in the audio track mixer. Then go to Special, and from there, Loudness Radar. Double click on it, and let's first explore the settings. You want to set the target loudness to minus 16, which is ideal for web or YouTube. And the speed, you can set that to 1 minute. So when we go back to the radar, an entire rotation is 1 minute of playback. So let's play back our timeline. The radar will now visualize the loudness of that playback. Now where it peaks into the yellow, we know to mix down the volume in those parts. It's also very useful to see a difference between two recordings. If one is louder than the other, we will instantly see that in the loudness radar. So you can kind of see this as a vector scope or waveform, but then for audio. Feature number 2! We all know that we can import an existing project file into Premiere. But did you know that you can also choose to import this as a shortcut? Well, this basically creates a shortcut in your project to another project. You can open that up and browse through it. Now, Adobe has a suggested workflow where you can create one project that is called the master project. Then you would create a new project in which you collect and organize all of your media. You create another project in which you have all the interviews. Another one with all the title sequences, and so on. So you create shortcuts in your master project to all those projects. And this gives you an overview, and you can easily jump between the different projects. Now, with a recent update of Premiere, they have introduced productions, which is kind of similar. You start by creating a production, which opens up a new production panel. And in here, we create new projects and organize it in a way that we want. So this replaces that master project idea, as it comes down to basically the same thing. Now my guess is that they want to build more features around this, which I would really appreciate. And now that we're talking about larger projects and organizations, did you know that there are various collaboration features? Yes, even if you don't have the Teams plan. In your preferences, under collaboration, you can find the option project locking. Enable that and type in your name. If someone else in your network is working inside a project that is part of a production, you can see that person's name next to it. But it also works with shortcut projects. Only here we have to right-click on the columns first, then go to metadata display and search for project locked. Enable it and press OK. That column now also appears in the project panel, and you get an overview of who is working in which project. For instance, me, Jordy, is working in a project, so it's locked, and someone else can only read from it and not make any adjustments. Someone can ask me to unlock the project, which I can do with this little button here in the bottom left corner. And then that person can make any adjustment to it. When I lock the project again, Premiere will refresh. So a very nice feature if you're working in Teams. And guys, you know what else is a super nice feature? Well, today's sponsor, Skillshare, because as you all know, we have a bunch of editing and filmmaking classes on Skillshare, like Adobe After Effects for beginners, color grading in Lumetri, and so much more. But what's so amazing about the platform is that with an active subscription, you have access to tens of thousands of other classes as well. Now, there's a recent class about Caleb and Niles who teaches you a very well foundation about filmmaking with your phone. They cover some interesting topics about different gear and lenses that you can use, but also some great filmmaking techniques. You can get in touch with the teachers through a discussion or upload your work for them to feedback. So definitely a class worth checking out. It's also a short class giving you time to learn a lot more new skills with all the creative classes that you can find. Now, if you click the first link in the description down below, the first 500 students will get 2 months for free. And after that, it's a super cheap price of less than $10 per month. So go check it out. And now let's continue with some more features in Adobe Premiere Pro. And as we previously saw, by right-clicking in the Project Panel's columns, you can choose Metadata Display. We can then toggle different columns, but there's an interesting feature right here. You can also create your own metadata. Simply click on Add Property, give it a name, and then choose the type of field it has to be. Let's take text as an example, press OK and OK again. You can now drag your new column more to the front if you like so. Now, this custom input field allows you to label your clips. For instance, you can say whether a clip is a close-up, a medium shot, or a long shot. After we've done that, we can click on the column to sort our shots based on that label. Moving on to the fifth feature you might not knew about before, and that can be found in the effects library. If you right-click in the empty space, you can choose to create a new custom bin. You can give that a name like My Effects, which after you can drag in the effects that you use the most. So you can always have that folder open and have direct access to those effects without having to search for it every time. A small feature, but it could be very useful. The next one, say that you've made an animation on some kind of an effect. You can then save that as a preset, but in the dialog box that appears, you have three options to save your animation as. And this refers to the keyframes that you've placed. Choosing scale will see your keyframes as a percentage. For instance, the last keyframe sits at 30% of the clip length. So when applying the preset to a much longer clip, the animation will also take longer as the keyframes scale over the length of the clip, because they're seen as in percentage. Now, choosing endpoint, the animation always stays the same speed, starting from the endpoint or start of the clip that you apply the preset to. And finally is outpoint, which looks at the end of the clip that you created the preset from. Applying this preset to a new clip that is longer, it will start your keyframes from the time of the outpoint from which you've created the preset. So usually you're gonna pick the endpoint or sometimes scale. And that brings us to the last one. As we all know, we can use the pen tool to create keyframes on audio clips to mix the sound. But every time that you start with a new clip, you'll need to adjust there as well. Well, let's have a look at the timeline. If you expand it, you'll find a keyframes menu. Now from there, you want to select track keyframes, volume. And right now we can create such keyframes on the track level. And this also has a great benefit where you can add new or swap audio clips without removing or breaking any of your keyframes. You can always go back to show clip keyframes to adjust each one individual if you like so. And those were my 7 features that you might not knew about before. At least I hope so. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you Skillshare for the support. Definitely check the link in the description down below. And as always, stay creative. Guys, I've been thinking about it, to try out DaVinci Resolve. What do you guys think about that? Should I try it out, or should I even start making tutorial videos about that program? It could be very interesting, but I don't know. DaVinci on a Premiere channel? Might be weird. I don't know. Let me know in the comments, guys. What do you think?